How's it going, everyone, and welcome back to my another Art Studio Lab video tutorial. Today's video, it's all about how to easily turn the type into gold in Adobe Photoshop. We will use the Photoshop layer styles to create this effect. We will create our own custom gold gradient and add some sparkles to it, using one of Photoshop's brushes to make our golden text really shine. So to create the golden type effect, begin by creating a new document in Adobe Photoshop. I'm using the canvas size of 2000 by 1000 pixels with 72 ppi resolution. To help our gold text really stand out, change the background color to black. So add a solid color adjustment layer at the bottom of the layers panel, then choose the black color. Grab the type tool from the tools menu group and choose your font in the top options bar. To make it simple, I'm using the Times New Roman font with bold font style. Set the type size to 72 points. We will resize the text once we've added. And since our background color is black, we will set the color of the text to white. Click inside the document and type your chosen wording. To accept it, click the check mark on the top options bar. Press the Ctrl or Command and T to transform, then resize the text. Press and hold the Shift key while dragging to avoid the letters being distorted, or to keep the aspect ratio of the letters in check. To align the text into the center, click inside the free transform box. Then drag the text into position. Hit the Enter key to accept it. Make the copy of the text. Press the Ctrl or Command and J to duplicate the text. Now we will apply the golden effect to the text. Double click the layer copy of the text and it opens the layer style dialog box. Then choose Gradient Overlay. Now we will edit the gradient and choose colors that look more golden. Click on the gradient preview bar, and on the gradient editor dialog box, double click on the left color stop. Choose the pale yellow of 246, 238, and 173 in the RGB values. Double click on the right color stop, and choose the golden color of 193, 172, and 81. We'll need to save this gradient into preset. Type the name you want, then click the new button to save it. The thumbnail of the gradient appears in the presets area, so we can select it again quickly in the next time we need it. Change the gradient style options from linear to reflected. This moves the gold color to the top and bottom of the letters, leaving the pale yellow color passing through the middle. Apply the bevel and emboss layer style. Change the technique to chisel hard, and on the shading section, click the little arrow to open the contour settings. Then open the contour profiles from the little settings icon. Append them to the existing list. Scroll down to find and select the ring double contour profile, the third one along in the grid. You can always come back and experiment with other contour profiles too. Check the anti-alias option to smooth out any jagged lines. Then add 120 degrees angle. Set the opacity for both highlights and shadows to 75%. Use the up arrow keys to increase the size of the value of the bevel. Continue increasing the size until you completely filled in the letters. Next is set the depth around 170% to enhance more lighting effect and adds more contrast to it. Then add an inner glow. Using the settings, multiply 50% opacity and the RGB value color of 232, 128, and 31. Increase the size of the glow until it completely covers the letters. back to the original type layer and double click to open the layer style box again. Choose stroke, then change the settings from color to gradient. Click the little arrow to the right, and after that, select the gold gradient we saved earlier. Change the gradient style options from linear to reflected. Then change the position to outside. Increase the size of the stroke to around 8 pixels. Add a bevel and emboss next. We apply it to the stroke. So change the settings of the style from inner bevel to stroke emboss. Change the technique to chisel hard, then set the size of the bevel to the same size as you used for your stroke, which is around 8 pixels. Make sure that the contour profile is set to ring double. And also, the anti-alias option is checked. Turn on the contour style. This will enhance the lighting around the stroke. Then finally, add the outer glow style. Using the settings 40% opacity, RGB value of 232, 128, and 31, just the same as the color of the inner glow. Then after that, increase the size of the glow to 50 pixels. To finish off the golden text with sparkling effect, grab the brush tool from the tools menu. Right-click anywhere inside the document to open the brush preset. Then click on the little settings icon and select assorted brushes. Append it into the brush list. Click this little icon again and choose smallest. This just let us see the names of the brushes rather than their thumbnails. Scroll down and find the crosshatch brush. The number beside it means the default size of the brush in pixels. So we choose the number 48 pixel brush. Or you can just resize the brush if you want. Sample a color from the highlight of the text. Press and hold the Alt or Option key to temporarily switch from the brush tool to the eyedropper tool. Then click to sample the highlight of the text. Add a new layer and make sure that it is above on the layer stack. Then click on a few random spots of the letters to add the sparkles. Use your left and right bracket keys to add some variety of brush size before each click. Don't add too many sparkles. Add some couple to each individual letters. Lower the opacity of the sparkles if you find it too bright. I'll go around 80%. And so, that's how we easily turn the text into gold using Photoshop layer styles and a brush to add some sparkling effect. The outer glow layer style helps add some glowing to the text, while the bevel and emboss layer style helps simulating the reflections. So I hope you find this tutorial useful. If you did, be sure to click the subscribe button. And don't forget to turn on your notifications so that you stick around for my all upcoming tips and tutorials. As always, thank you so much for watching and see you on the next one.